Right, we've reached that part of the show where two guys get to put on the gloves and have a bit of a debate. And thank you, gentlemen, for agreeing to it, especially to our guests for today. And today's debate is all about the involvement of one French club, Montpellier, with a South African school, Grey College. Now, they've launched a unique scholarship program. An unnamed, unknown donor or international businessman is said to be behind the Badawi Legacy Scholarship Program. And there will be a sort of an exchange going on. There'll be bursaries up for grabs, all in a bid to try and help, I suppose, Grey College or Grey College's coffers. But of course, the inverse is that it might just lead to French clubs having a little bit more access to South African rugby talent. But saying that it is a good thing that Montpellier is involved with Grey College will be you, Jacques. So over to you.
Yeah. For Montpellier, I think they've got one of the best schools in South Africa as a breeding ground for them. You know, for the players after school to go to Montpellier and have a chance to play in France and get experience there is massive. So for them, it's a win-win, you know. So and also for Grey College, you know, I think the cash injection they will get from that is going to be massive for them.
Yeah, they'll get the cash, won't they? And they'll certainly get some support. They'll have some French teachers teaching in the school. But realistically, all that's going to do is equip those players who arrive in France to understand the coach. Because this Badawi scholarship program is going to turn out, in my opinion, to be a Badawi player stealership program. Because those guys are going to head out the best players, aren't they? That the only reason they're investing in Grey College is because it's a breeding ground. If they were really trying to do something good, real some investment in South Africa, particularly in our social environment, they'd be sponsoring a school in one of the previously disadvantaged areas that really needs the financial support, the sporting support, and maybe an element of international opportunity to travel.
But saying that also, Joel, for them, I mean, it's a wealthy businessman. For them, it's business. You know, they want the best players to come and play for their club. They want to win a championship. For them, it's all about getting the best the best players.
But I don't want to get in an arm wrestle with you because I've seen the size of those guns. but the other side of that is we see French touts at the Craven Week already. We see them watching schoolboy games. They're here. They're trying to steal our players. This is just another way of them stealing our players. We see Rory Cocker's played for France. There's a whole host of South African players who are playing there who will become eligible in the near future. I think SA Rugby should be fearful of this. They need to somehow find a mechanism to stop those likes going to France at a young age. Maybe there's some sort of transfer fee, development fee, some real proper cost involved, but we need to stop our young players going there because we need strong systems in this country and we need all our talent to stay and play here.
We need strong system. Also saying that we need financial backing also to back the players to stay in South Africa. At the moment, it's not the case. You know, players want to go play overseas. They want to earn the big money and they want to get exposure overseas to play there. So for me, you know, I think it's a good thing for Grey College and for Montpellier in the next couple of years, they're going to be a very strong club.
Yeah, and I think it's a fair point. But for me, it's the senior players like yourself who go play in Japan towards the latter part of your very young career. Yeah. you go play overseas and you cash in. And the All Blacks have got that right, haven't they? Those players, they treasure playing in New Zealand, they treasure playing for the national team, and they go and earn their cash right at the end of the career. We need that type of thought process as opposed to our youngsters buggering off and us losing the talent.
I'm going to side in with him just briefly and play devil's advocate. Yeah. What about the business of school? What about the business of making sure there's enough funding to create this rugby nursery?
Yeah, absolutely. That is absolutely. And they're going to put some money in. But from what I understand, the investment is a few scholarships, which is great. Yeah. I mean, let's accept that. That is fantastic to give. And hopefully, they are two previously disadvantaged individuals who can't afford to go to a school like Grey College or one of the big schools. And it really is meaningful for those kids as opposed to a scholarship for a young rugby player who then effectively shoots over to the other side of the world. The other financial investment is French teachers to teach the language, which also makes sense because if you are multilingual, it does give you a big advantage. But really, in this country, do we need our kids speaking French?
No.
We need them playing rugby on our fields.
Yeah, for sure.
Right, but I can say that I think both gentlemen would be in agreement if there were strong measures in place to make sure that our players don't just get taken or stolen willy-nilly.
And just to add to that, that's a hell of a good point because they could they could go over there, gain experience, but we want them
and
to come
back. Absolutely. Yeah. So joining the conversation, use that hashtag SSRugby. Weigh in on the debate. What do you think? Good thing, bad thing that a French club is so closely linked to one of South Africa's biggest rugby nurseries in Grey College. But we change focus now to the Currie Cup, and to kick things off, as we do every week, let's take a look at the direct access support play of the match.